Hello and welcome to our first ever Pennsylvania Coronavirus Pandemic Update video for Wednesday, October 19th, 2022. This is going to be a new weekly series that we do. Pennsylvania, my state that I live in, updates every week, and our weekly updates are on Wednesdays. Alrighty, let's get into this. We have some problems with the data this week in Pennsylvania. It's pretty much a mixture of all over the place. Cases are down in our state this week, but down for the wrong reasons. First off, 10,843 cases were reported this week. That's actually down a good amount from last week. Why? Well, one of the reasons is because Philadelphia County has not provided an update for multiple days in a row of cases. So therefore, without Philadelphia data, it's incomplete. So we will show that in a minute, because I am going to show the Philadelphia data dashboard in a minute. Taking a look at deaths this week. Yeah, 140 deaths this week. That is way up from the previous week. Not good at all. Something else that is up from last week, despite cases being down. Look at this. Last week at this time, there were around 1,686 people in the hospital. This weekend at this time, look at that. We're now up to 1,742 people in the hospital. Also, ICUs have been increasing throughout the week. Not good. Which kind of explains, with the ICUs increasing, it can definitely show you why there's been more deaths. But I am concerned. Our deaths have been increasing and staying elevated for multiple weeks now, and this is not good. Let's take a look deeper at Pennsylvania's hospital situation. 1,742 people in the hospital for coronavirus. Overall, inpatient bed use in our state is at 24,588. 80.04% of all beds in Pennsylvania are currently in use. 5.73% of beds are being used for coronavirus. Let's take this a little bit deeper, shall we? Let's take a look at Pennsylvania as a whole. So as you can see here, daily cases, yes, they are somewhat dropping on our dashboard. But I express caution here. Let's go down to Philadelphia County. Look at that. The last update out of Philadelphia County was back on the 11th. That's 8 days without cases coming from Philadelphia County. And if I go to Philadelphia's dashboard, let's take a look at the trends in summary here. This should show it, hopefully. Yeah, look here. We go up to about the 9th, yep, and then after the 9th, the 16th. So you mean tell me there are only 5 cases on the 16th? Oh, so we have multiple days of missing data, and therefore the state's cases are down this week. You can also look at something else here in Philadelphia County, which I find rather interesting. We do wastewater in Philadelphia County. So the southwest section of the city, it's down up to the 9th. It's flat in the southwest, but look what happened up to the 9th of this month. The 9th of this month. Wastewater starting to go up in the northeast section of Philadelphia. That's not good. That's indicating that there is an increase in cases in northeast Philadelphia. All right, let's go back to the state dashboard, shall we? Allegheny. Let's take a look at Allegheny County. That's the other biggest state or biggest city in the state. And last report was 110 cases in Allegheny County. So Allegheny County cases are somewhat going down. And I do have Allegheny's dashboard here somewhere. Hang on. Here we go. Yes, Allegheny County. So let's take a look at the COVID-19 summary for Allegheny County. And you can see here, they are currently at 11.9% positivity overall. The 7-day average is at 13.9%. So that is actually relatively high. That's not good. Not good at all. And not something that we want to see. We want to see the positivity drop, but right now the positivity is relatively high out there. So continuing on with Pennsylvania, there's another county that's relatively important to look at, and that is Center County. And the reason why Center County is important is because there's something that goes on in Center County. Penn State football. We have some big weekends coming up at Penn State. You have the Minnesota game this weekend, which is homecoming. Then you have the all-important Ohio State game, which is going to be a sellout. And as you know, if you're from Pennsylvania, Beaver Stadium on these big games can get as high as 110,000 people. So, yeah, I'm concerned that's going to cause a massive spike, and I'll show you what's going on there in a minute. But at the moment, cases are somewhat dropping. But if you look back when the students went back and games first started, there were a period where cases in Center County, they went up to anywhere between 50 to 100 cases, almost 100 cases in a day. That's a lot of cases for Center County. It has since dropped some with some of these away games, and some of these home games as recently were not as big of crowds. But that is going to change. Let's take a look at the dashboard for Mount Nittany, which is the hospital in Center County. Back on the 13th, there were only 4 people in the hospital. Before that, it was up and then it dropped. Look what's happened ever since. COVID-19 hospitalized patient, it's now up to 16. So it's really gone up in the past week. And we got a big game weekend coming up this weekend up there. There's another big game weekend following that. I don't see how this does not continue to go up. And we'll continue to track this. And I definitely foresee it continuing to go up. All right, we can also take a look at Lehigh Valley. Lehigh Valley patients in the hospitals, as of October 17th, they have 93 patients in the hospitals. This is down ever so slightly. At one point, it was up to 150, but it's dropped somewhat. And I suspect eventually that's going to start reversing and going up again. We're seeing the hospitalizations as a statewide total go up ever so slightly, but I think that's going to probably pick up the pace. Because remember, Pennsylvania lags New York by a couple weeks. New York State has been rising relatively quick with hospitalizations. So I think within a couple weeks, it'll be Northeast Pennsylvania first. Because remember, a lot of people in Northeast Pennsylvania commute to and from New York City, which is seeing that increase right now. Then, after that, it will eventually spread to the rest of the state. Because a lot of people in Northeast Pennsylvania that live there will give it to the people that come up from maybe Southeast Pennsylvania that head up there for the weekend, and so on. It gets a good mixture throughout the state. That's the way it works. Now, continuing on with our tour in Pennsylvania, I would like to take a look at the CDC transmission map. As you can see here, the majority of our state is in high levels of transmission. There are a few counties, and if it lets me change it, here we go. There are a few counties that are not and are in substantial transmission. Sullivan County, Snyder County, Adams County, Lebanon County, and of course Philadelphia County. Now, I believe Philadelphia County is only in substantial transmission for one reason. We have multiple days where COVID cases were not reported, and that to me is a problem. All right, let's go over to the varying proportions here. We represent Region 3. So here's the variance for Region 3. BA.5, 67.9%. BA.4.6, 12.2%. BQ.1.1, 5.7%. BQ.1, 5.7%. BF.7, 5.3%. BA.2.7, 5.2, 1.4%. BA.2.75, 1.3%. BA.4, 0.6%. And again, this is Region 3, which Pennsylvania is in Region 3. Alrighty, in conclusion, what's going on here in Pennsylvania? Well, if we come back to the hospitalizations, we have 1,742 people in the hospital right now. If we go back to the dashboard here, not dashboard, Medivis website, let's just go back real quickly. Back to last year at this time, 10-19. So on October 19th of last year, we did have 3,000 people in the hospital. But, mind you, we're just on the cusp of this new BQ variant wave, which is going to be coming to Pennsylvania soon. So I think our hospitalizations are either going to hold steady, like they have for the last month. I mean, we've been in this 1,500 to 1,800 range. I think eventually we're going to break our shell on past 2,000 hospitalizations, whether it be this week or next week. The other thing that's concerning to me in our state is, look at this capacity. 80.04% of all beds are already used in Pennsylvania. We know flu cases are starting to rise in our state. The flu tracker will be starting from Pennsylvania soon. Hopefully I'll have it for next week. We know there's also cases of RSV in children, which that is concerning as well. So there's a lot of hospital use going on right now, and there's a tremendous strain for this early in the season for our state. I am going to continue to watch the hospital capacity. It is deeply concerning. And remember, we can't go by how many beds there are because there is a staffing shortage here in the state of Pennsylvania in hospitals. And I have personally heard on dispatch. I listen to dispatch sometimes in Southeast PA. I've also listened to Center County a lot, especially during home games. But I've heard of hospitals in Southeast PA already going on divert. So, yeah, we have to concern ourselves about hospital capacity. And we'll see what happens with cases. Cases are not rising right now in the state, but the hospitalizations, as you saw here, are holding steady. And we're at the high end right now of the range that we've been in for the past several months. So, okay, thank you for watching this Pennsylvania update video. We'll have another one next week on Wednesday, or if there's any special updates that change is between now and then. If you want to see more stuff like this, hit the like and subscribe button down below. And thanks for watching. And stay safe, everyone.